Welcome into the Chiefs Report. I am your host, Harrison Graham. Lots of rumors and news surrounding the Kansas City Chiefs as we creep closer and closer to free agency. More focused on the draft today. Lots of mock drafts have been coming out since the NFL Combine came to an end. Everybody releases their post-combine mock. We know how that goes. Three separate ones have the Chiefs selecting a defensive tackle in round one. CBS Sports, NFL Network took Ross Blacklock out of TCU. And then ESPN's Todd McShay took Justin Matabuke out of Texas A&M. Keep in mind, Chiefs are using the franchise tag on Chris Jones. Maybe a trade could be in his future. We will see and talk about that in just a sec. Speaking of mock drafts, my guy Tom Downey released his post-combine mock draft. Go check it out on our main Chat Sports YouTube channel, youtube.com/chatsportsTV. Find out who the Chiefs took in his mock draft. All right, you compare Blacklock and Matabuke side by side. Pretty similar production there. Tackles for loss, sacks. Matabuke had a couple of more, 40 tackles each. Certainly, the A&M product was a little bit more productive this past season, but Blacklock, I think, has a little bit more explosiveness. Both are kind of fringe first-round targets. That's what the Chiefs are picking with the number 32 overall pick. So we'll see if one of these players becomes an option for Kansas City in April's draft. What do you guys think the better draft strategy is? I go back and forth on this. I think it depends on where you are as a franchise. For the Chiefs, they're in a really good spot. Don't have a ton of major needs, so I'm typing my one for best available. I think you almost always should take the best available player. Don't reach for a pick just because it fills a need. Trade down if you feel like you need to fill a need, but the best player there, it's like 10 picks away. Go ahead and trade back. So I'm typing my one for best available. Let me know what you guys think down in the comments section. All right, Chiefs fans, go ahead and get signed up, or not signed up, subscribe to our Chiefs only channel. You see the link down below, youtube.com/ChiefsTV. Once you get over there, hit that big red button. Just crossed 1,500 subs. Let's get to 2,000 very, very soon. We'll have full Chiefs offseason covered for the next couple of months leading up to the 2020 NFL season. youtube.com/ChiefsTV. I mentioned Chris Jones. Could a trade be on the table? Bleacher Report released their tag and trade candidates, and Chris Jones was one of them. Lots of different players on their list. Makes some sense, right? Now, certainly the Chiefs want to get a long-term deal done. Jones wants to stay in Kansas City. He's talked about building a dynasty for Kansas City and being a big part of that, but Chiefs have less than $14 million in projected cap space. We saw Kansas City do this with Dee Ford last year, getting a second-round pick in return. Now, I don't think they would do it for a second-round pick for Chris Jones because I think he's more disruptive. I think he's more valuable. But if you can get a first-round pick in return, I got to think there's some kind of possibility that the Chiefs are going to consider that, considering he might cost upwards of $20 million per season. Now, would you trade Chris Jones for a first-round pick? Type Y for yes, type N for no. Obviously, not all first-round picks are created equal, but is it the 20th pick? I might consider it. I might save $20 million for a top 20 pick. That might be worth it. Go ahead and cast your votes down in the comments section. And while you're doing that, go click on the link that's in the comments and in the description, chatsports.com/Chiefs hoodies. We got different types of them, all kinds of hoodies, some of them Super Bowl champs ones. You get this custom one, you get your name on it, pretty good price on that one as well. And then this little workout short sleeve Mahomes hoodie, I think there's Travis Kelce and a couple of other guys as well. It's less than $60. Usually those are upwards of $100. chatsports.com/Chiefs hoodies. That is the place to go to find all kinds of different Chiefs hoodies on sale. Go take advantage. Again, the link is in the comments and in the description. You look at this Chiefs defensive line depth chart, it looks good if all these guys are back, but you know, Chris Jones, he's going to be franchise tagged, could be traded. We'll see what happens there. Hopefully a long-term deal comes. Pinnell's a free agent, Xavier Williams, Emmanuel Ogba, they're all free agents as well. I'd like to bring back Pinnell. You feel good about Frank Clark and Alex Okafor coming off the edge. That interior is where you have some free agents coming up this offseason and where the Chiefs have to make a big decision, especially with Chris Jones. I hope the Chiefs don't tag and trade Chris Jones, but I'm not surprised we're seeing articles about this being a possibility. We saw it with Dee Ford last year. The Chiefs cap situation isn't great. You got to extend Patrick Mahomes at some point. Got to make a decision on Sammy Watkins. Trading Chris Jones, unfortunately, it is a possibility. Thank you so much for watching the Chiefs Report. If you want my three positions the Chiefs should target in the first round of the NFL draft, go ahead and click this video right here. And If you want Chiefs rumors, news, full off-season coverage, go ahead and subscribe to the Chiefs Report right here. Let's get to 2,000 subs. Go Chiefs.